Hey, it's Button here, and in this video we're going to have a look at this server. This is an HP Proleon G5DR360, which might be an old server, but it's good enough for me. My specific variant has an Intel Xeon 5150 CPU, 6 GB of RAM, 272 GB hard drives, and I also have another 2 hard drives stored away from the server in case the current 2 hard drives fail. Alright, enough talking about the specs, let's talk about how I set it up. Just a friendly reminder, if you are setting up a server of your own, you might probably want to look for a better video, but it's up to you what you want to do. The first question was the operating system. I originally wanted to go with Ubuntu server because I'm working with a server after all, but the last time I tried to install Java on that, I somehow managed to break the installation, resulting in it not booting. I also wanted to make it easy to manage for my friend Trainmol, since he's also going to use the server for some projects of his. I still wanted a Debian-based Linux distribution though, because it's what I'm most familiar with, and I know everything I need will run there without any major problems. So I went googling for the most lightweight Debian-based distro, and I found Lubuntu. This lightweight Linux distribution is designed for older PCs, so it's ideal when I want a GUI, but don't want to put too much strain on the server.
I had to fit Lubuntu onto a 700 MB CD, because I didn't have any other installation media at hand. I couldn't install the newest version straight away, because it was 200 megs over. So I had to use version 12.04 instead.
And this one almost didn't make it either.
Only 3 MB more, and I would be screwed. But that's not all problems I've had with the installation media. The first time I tried to burn the ISO, my laptop's battery died, which resulted in the CD getting damaged and unusable. So I had to take a second CD and burn it again. This time it was successful.
However, the installation itself didn't go without any problems either. First, there was this graphical glitch when I moved the window. But Linux is known to be buggy with AMD cards, so I waited for the installation to finish to see if anything actually breaks. Then the screen randomly went black for a few minutes. I wanted to hard reset the server, but I also wanted to have it recorded. And since my phone was full, I had to free up some space there. And when I was finally ready to record, I was greeted with the installation complete, please restart the system screen. The basic OS installation was done at this point, but I was running a 5-year-old version, so I wanted to upgrade it, of course. I thought that I escaped all of the problems. But then this message box popped up. It was complaining about X screensaver running in the background. I opened Task Manager and couldn't find the process there. So I decided to restart the server. It still couldn't upgrade though, because of some permissions error. So I decided to upgrade through Terminal. Then the upgrade finally finished, and I restarted the server once again. The first program I installed was TeamViewer, mainly because of the integrated screen recorder, which helped me a lot while creating this video. The second thing I set up was a Minecraft server, because that was going to be the main purpose of this machine for a while. I also installed PacketMine, so we can create a Packet Edition server later.
I wanted to get an idea about the performance, so I wanted to try some Windows-based benchmarking tools through Vine. I installed Vine, downloaded Cinebench, and it crashed. I quickly realized that this is not the way to go, and that I should look for some benchmarking tools made specifically for Ubuntu. After about 10 minutes of searching on Google, I found Hardinfo, which was actually installed on the system already, as a default package. Here are the benchmark results compared to both my desktop and my laptop, along with some of the specs. I've also tried Minecraft, which has surprisingly worked. The performance was very poor though, about 3 FPS. So now all I wanted to do with the server before it could go online was done. The server was finally ready to go. So I put the server into the car and went to Trainmol's house. I don't have any footage of me bringing the server into the house, because I was too busy with carrying the server, obviously. But I have this photo of his temporary setup at least. Alright, so this is the end, thanks for watching. If you liked the video, press the like button. If you didn't, press the dislike button and tell me why. And goodbye everybody!